Hello everyone, and welcome back to Mafia 1 Definitive Edition. Let's continue the story, shall we? Things are picking up. And, yeah. See how this next episode's gonna go. Changed a few settings, maybe the game will look a little bit better.
Hey, Bass. I came as soon as I got your message.
Sit down, Tom. We have a mole, Tom.
No. Who?
I was up all night driving myself nuts trying to figure it out. I started thinking maybe it's one of our guys. We aren't paying his fair share. Someone with a light wallet.
Maybe looking to Morello for a new suit.
Frank wasn't around, so I went to the safe to get the account books. To see who's getting cents on the dollar he's earned.
What do you know?
The books are gone, Tom.
Frank.
More than 50 years I've known him. Everything I have, I got with Frank. And every buck we've earned, every dime we've paid out, it's all logged in those books. Frank hands those over to the feds, we're finished.
Frank respects one person in this whole town, and that's you. This has got to be some kind of misunderstanding.
I've been calling him all day. I went by his place. He's gone. His wife and kid are gone.
But why?
I don't know. I'm sure he has his reasons. Maybe he's still smarting over the dog.
But when you tried to drown.
Yeah. Same one I shot after he wouldn't let me sink her. I was a stupid kid, Tommy. But grudge or no grudge, we gotta get those books back. Shake down all our stoolies. See who knows what. When you catch up to Frank, you get those books. And if he doesn't have them on him, you make him tell you where to find them. After that, you do what we gotta do.
Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car.
Oh no, not Frank. Anybody but Frank.
Tough day today, Tom.
We gotta keep a lid on this, Tom. Start with Biff, but don't give him nothing. I got you a clean set of wheels. Something special here, if you want it. When Frank sees a LaPara, he'll know. The old ways work.
Alright, so we gotta get Frank. It's gonna be sad. Gotta go to the Biff's pawn shop. Not a bad car.
The Akron was destroyed in a violent thunderstorm off the New Jersey coast Tuesday morning with the loss of 73 of 76 aboard. The disaster stands as the worst aviation accident on record. Yesterday, one of the survivors, Lieutenant Commander Herbert B. Wiley, spoke to members of the press and gave a brief account of the tragedy. He also spoke of the survivor's rescue by the German tanker, Phoebus.
Okay. I can run now at least.
Tommy, what's the rumpus?
Heard any big news lately? Something that Don might want to know.
Depends. What's it worth to you?
$20.
How about 40?
All right, spill.
The FBI's in town. They're getting something from Morello, but I don't know what.
How'd you hear?
Little Tony got some guy drunk in the Black Cat and drove him home. Heard a bunch of stuff, so he's the guy you want to see.
Okay. Thanks.
Let's go to the Black Cat.
Welcome to a WLH sports report. There's a sense of anticipation as we await the start of the big game. Our very own Lost Heaven Lancers are out on the road, deep in enemy territory as they take on bitter rivals, the Empire Bay Cannons. This year's Gold Series is shaping up to be one of the best on record, with both teams matching one another blow for blow. Despite the Cannons...
I love how every car has, like, white walls.
The series, the Lancers have bounced back and have really taken their rivals to task. Many of the plaudits and column inches have been dedicated to one man. Lancers pitcher Bunny Smith is one of this year's standout performers. And with this series tied at 3-3, he may well be the key man that brings the Wiseman Trophy back to Last Heaven. But doing so will be no easy task, as standing in his way is opposition captain, Jack Seidel. His solo home run in the bottom of the fifth inning of Game 5 turned events in favor of the Empire Bay team. Victory was canceled out by the Lancers in Game 6, and we now have a powder keg finale that is sure to have everyone glued to their radios. Can Bunny Smith bring it home for Lost Heaven?
All right.
The Cannons' towering redhead have the final say. WLH 570 Lost Heaven Radio will carry live coverage of the final game of the Gold Series, and we hope you'll join us in wishing our boys...
Territels.
Nah, it's not. What's this about the guy you drove home who's with the feds?
He came in for a drink, which turned into 10. He's hired muscle for some kind of safe house.
Where?
Oak Hill, corner of Pine. He gave me $10 to drive him back and keep my mouth shut. Let on that Councilor Gilati's brokered some kind of deal between Morello and the FBI. They were all ready to sit tight on someone in there.
Why the hell didn't you tell us?
Tom, I did. I came in to see French straight away. He didn't tell the Don?
No, he didn't.
Tom? What's going on?
Coverage of Game 7 of the Gold Series. And by the looks of it, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be underway any minute now. The crowd here in the Armory are restless. You can almost taste the tension as we approach this, the deciding game between these two famous rivals. More than a little bad blood between
I hope
them, and
we're probably going to have to clip Frank, huh?
Of course, this
that
occasion,
sucks.
More than any other, could prove feisty, what with the drama that closed out the previous game. That, of course, saw the Lancers win to tie the series, and it's not often Empire Bay and Lost Heaven can boast the game's best cutting hitter and pitcher, respectively. I refer, of course, to Foghorn Seidel, a man mountain with a shock of red hair, and Lancers star...
Oh, don't you fucking come on to my side of the road.
Say, ...between his teammates, issuing last-minute orders. They seem responsive to whatever he's saying. He commands respect from his team, that is for sure. By goodness, there must be some nerves among some of the younger Lancers. Elms, Graveson, and Nicholson. Smith seemed to have pepped them up. That's good to see. That's what a good captain does. The Cannons lineup is meandering over to the home team dugout. The Lancers are slowly taking up their position, so we can't be too far away from the opening pitch here at the Armory, the home of the Empire Bay Cannons. Stay with us for more.
Really? Hitting a car is enough to warrant a police search? Oh, okay.
Officers downtown. Some fella near you is driving like a madman.
The energy kick, it's a taste sensation. When you're in need of a lift, choose Swift.
Fair enough. Turn that off. I hope I don't get a copyright claim from that. I don't think so.
Looks like the place.
Are we gonna tell somebody? Yeah.
Take me to those account books, Frank. Where are they moving you to?
Yeah, take that right.
Gotta be some kind of meet happening. Shit. They've taken you to the airport, Frank.
long-ass tailing mission, huh? Yeah, the airport.
Christ, they're flying him out of state or something. Fuck, this ain't good.
Oh no. Maybe I can get around back. Hide this guy. Should be fine.
Morello hasn't the honor to even show his face.
For a rat like you? Nah. Get in the car.
So what happens next? Once Morello books our accounting guys go to...
Francoletti. Oh, God. You hurt, man. Come on, come around the corner. I'm dead. Oh, I'm surprised I'm not dead.
I got him.
Tom.
Frank. The Don sent me.
I figured as much. I'm sorry it had to be you, Tommy.
Anything you want me to tell him?
I wish it could have shaken out better, but Morello finally came after me. It's okay. You can come out. Morello offered me a simple trade. The Don's account books for our lives and tickets out of this town.
You hand the books over yet?
I'm not so stupid, Tom. They're safe. Morello was waiting for this. It's a key to a box in the Grand Imperial Bank downtown. I told Morello I'd hand it over after the plane was fueled and ready to go. His men were meant to fetch it before we left.
I took care of them. Told them to get on a plane.
Go on, March. Alice, get aboard.
Frank, you're coming with us.
Not right now, honey. Just get buckled in. Tommy and I, we have some serious business to discuss.
But Frank...
Get on the plane, March. For Alice. For me. Get on the goddamn plane, please.
You been paid yet?
Yeah.
Now you've been paid twice. You take the ladies wherever they want to go.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Tom.
Christ, Frank. Why didn't you ask us for help?
I guess I just wanted out. One way or the other. I'm tired, Tommy. Tired of lying to my wife. Tired of checking under my car every time I take a Sunday drive. And tired of waiting for the Don to put two in my temple.
Don't do it. Don't do it.
God damn you, Frank.
afternoon, sir.
Where's the safety deposit boxes?
With my colleague downstairs, sir.
Thanks.
Why do I feel like we're gonna have to rob the bank?
Beautiful day, huh?
Uh-huh.
Keeping out of trouble, I hope.
Oh. Bankster's Monthly.
I need to access the deposit boxes for Frank Coletti.
Ah, yes. Mr. Angelo?
Yeah.
Mr. Coletti said it might be you who came, and to provide access. Please, follow me.
All right. Let's follow the bank clerk.
Got the books and covered my tracks. Salieri never asked any questions. In fact, apart from the funeral, I never heard him talk about Frank again.
Burn Frank's house.
You're making my boys twitchy, Marco.
Sergio and I just came by to pay respects, that's all. Known Frank a long time. Almost as long as you. He's a good man. Smart. Loyal. Loyal to his wife. His kid above all else. There must be some kind of honor in that in you.
Maybe. But I'm still looking at this headstone with his little girl's name on it.
It's a hell of a thing.
They actually, like, came to the funeral. Visiting rich people.
Look at these houses. Big yards, white picket fences. It's the American dream, eh, Tommy?
I suppose.
Not for you?
No, sir. I like being closer to the business.
Don't let the flower beds and front porches fool you. There's more criminals out here than in the rest of the city combined.
Are that why we're in the neighborhood?
In a way. Morell's got a dirty prosecutor on his payroll named Watkins. Turns out he's old friends with Galati.
The city councilor?
The same. Morell let drop that we might have had something to do with the Galati boy's death. Now Watkins is loaded for bear, trying to do right by his buddy. Word is, he's striking gold with a few witnesses.
You have names?
Yeah. But Paulie and Sam are taking care of them. I'm putting you on a different part of the job. We need whatever Watkins has got on us.
Well, where's he holding?
A safe in his villa.
I'm no safe cracker.
Don't worry about that. We're taking you to meet Salvatore. He's fresh off the boat, but he knows how to pop open anything. Just get him into the villa, find the safe, and he'll do the rest.
What kind of rumpus should I expect?
Nothing you can't handle. Watkins is going to the theater, so the house should be empty except for a bit of muscle. The office is on the first floor, and our stoolie says the safe is in the wall. Once Salvatore has the safe open, grab all the evidence and get out.
That him, boss?
Yeah, that's our guy. Salvatore, tutto bene?
Sì, grazie, Don Salieri.
Good to see you. You know the job. Don't let me down.
Sì,
O capisco.
Tommy, if you bump into Watkins, don't kill him. It'll just bring down more heat.
You got it, boss.
Buona fortuna, ragazzi.
Tommy Angelo. Piacere di conoscerti.
Meraviglioso. Per favore.
Oh, we gotta go to the mansion.
Parli almeno un po' di italiano? Il capo ti ha detto il piano?
I don't speak Italian.
Eccellente. Fantastico.
No
plan?
Yeah, the boss told me.
Please. Understand. Entriamo dal labirinto senza farci sentire né vedere. La cassaforte è dietro un dipinto al primo piano. Dammi un po' di tempo e lascia fare tutto a me. Quella cassaforte avrà sicuramente un allarme.
Yeah. This is gonna be a long night for the both of us.
Cristo santo.
Okay, my turn. Do what I do. Do not get caught.
Sì.
You gotta keep safe.
Safe? Sì. It's my job. Apro cassaforte. Open safe.
Christ. Okay. Radio. Let's listen to the radio.
Eccellente.
Hell of a view up here.
A volte questo paese è stupendo. Ecco, entriamo da lì.
Over wall.
Labirinto.
What?
Vedrai.
Oh, a maze.
Sì, un labirinto.
Stay here while I take out the guards.
A quanto pare in America hanno il labirinto.
Let's take out these guys. So there's something up here.
Sure wish I could have a night off.
Hmm. was close.
Sure wish I could have a night off.
I'm gonna take this guy out.
There's someone in the maze.
Really? Yeah, might as well kill me. That's so stupid. Why did he turn around? Oh, for fuck's sake. Alright, let's take this guy out. Yeah, this is the guy that got me. Yeah, fuck this guy. Okay, what is your plan? What's your walk pattern, bro?
Sure wish I could have a night off.
I feel like if I get... Okay, I don't know why he didn't move that time. Let's take this guy down. Don't you dare. Don't you do it. What are you doing? Okay, good, good, good.
I think that's all of them.
Salvatore! Where are you? We're clear.
Tommy!
Where the hell did he go?
Sono qui, Tommy.
Guy's a pain in the ass.
Vieni con me. Tommy, I hear.
Uff, sei un tipo tosto, eh?
What?
Not gonna be able to understand a word he's saying.
Open. Geek.
What kind of luck picker are you?
Look for a...
What?
Da Vinci, Caravaggio, I capito.
Painting? You're saying it's behind a painting?
See, see.
Okay, I understand.
Non quello.
Guess we got another room to check. Gotta be it.
Is there anything anywhere else in the house? Yeah, yeah.
There's one. Another here, Salvatore. Only wall behind here.
That'll be on the first floor. It's gonna be a shootout.
stay out of our way and you won't get hurt.
Uh-oh. Yeah, of course.
Bravo.
Scusa.
Sure. Show me what you can do. Shit. Be quick, Salvatore.
Pacienza, pacienza.
Doesn't matter. Come on, we need to get out of here.
Vai dietro, dietro.
They gotta be upstairs. Jason is done.
Salvatore, stay back! I'll deal with him.
Hear that?
Getting down! Hurry on me! He's down!
Set him on fire! Throw in some fire!
First time.
Forza! Andiamocene!
Let's get in this one. Okay, maybe this isn't a good idea. Damn it. Really? Really? I'm dead. Why can't I go through that? That's so stupid. That's actually stupid.
Presto! Semina gli spiriti!
I know! Whatever you're saying, I know!
Police?
Well, if I can't take a shortcut... Oh, I can destroy that one, though.
Salvatore, where do I take you now?
Home.
Yeah, where home?
Six and Naples.
Okay, let's go.
Surprisingly, they didn't go down where we came in at. Not a bad car.
Tommy, devo dirti una cosa. Al nostro prossimo lavoro penso io alla cassaforte. Hai capito? Ci ho quasi rimesso la pelle in quella villa ed è tutta colpa tua. E impara almeno un po' d'italiano per rispetto della nostra patria. Ah, è come parlare al mio cane, lo so, ma Cristo, dovevo dirlo. Non farlo mai più. Mai più.
Ok, ok. Sure.
Good night.
Night.
All right. Great deal.
This is the last of the good stuff, boss.
I know. Some of those bottles I've had for 10 years. But we gotta make payroll. Get it out of here.
You heard him. Load it up.
Good to see you, boys.
Boss, any word on a job I pulled with Salvatore?
You did fine, Tom. Galati's got nothing on us now. We bought some time. At least until the money runs out.
Don't go selling off the farm yet, boss.
Sam says you worked out an angle.
Yeah. And you're gonna love it. We make a few bucks and knock out a couple of Morello's teeth, too.
Okay, what's the rumpus?
A couple of weeks ago, I'm relaxing in the cigar lounge at the Blue Tropics.
Where?
Some small-time whorehouse. It's just a couple of closets with some mattresses on the floor.
It's a gentleman's club. They got a bar and everything. Anyways, one of the Johns is soused, and he's crying to the madam about all his troubles. He catches my ear on account of his goofy accent. He's going on and on about how he just landed this huge payday. But the goons he's working for are already twisting his arm, and he's got the busted nose to show for it.
You pick up his tab?
Hell no. But I walked him out of the place, took him to the diner around the corner to sober up. We get to talking. Turns out his name is Gates. He's this hick up from Kentucky.
Moonshiner?
Better. His pop's got a couple of real distilleries, and I'll give you one guess as to their exclusive buyer around these parts.
Morello.
And you think he wants to burn bridges?
Oh, yeah. I've been working him steady, boss. He's bringing up another shipment tonight, but he's got his entire crew ready to roll over. All we gotta do is make it look like a proper heist.
I don't know, Polly. You really trust this guy?
He's got no love for Morello, I'll tell you that. Not like we got a lot of options here. We'll be cutting up the last beam pretty soon, boss.
What do you think, Tom?
We need to replace the Canadian. If Polly says this Gates can do that, I'm in.
Where's the meat?
The big parking garage downtown.
Okay, do it. But you better not be playing grab ass this time. You take Carlo and little Bill with you.
Sure thing, boss.
Once you have the truck, drive it back here.
We won't let you down, boss.
Don't make me regret giving you some time out there in the streets with the guys, Carlo.
You don't have to worry about me.
I'll keep your driver safe, boss.
Sam and little Bill said to meet him downtown. Okay, Carlo? Looking kind of like you shit yourself.
Ah, get bent.
Big moment, huh? Finally running with the pack.
Listen, I spend more time with a Dom than all of you's put together.
Sure, sat out on the road waiting till he's finished with his broad.
All right,
if you don't want to come, I won't. It's fine. Boss doesn't have to know.
Nah, you're coming. The boss said you're coming. Just, you got a face like you're being taken for an airing. I don't want Gates thinking we're frails.
Why is Gates selling Morello anyways?
First time Gates pulled in with his trucks, Morello decided to change up the terms. The big guy himself popped him in a nose as part of their renegotiation.
His nose is gonna get more than a pop if Morello hears we're involved.
That's why we're pretending to stick him up. Then he'll go back to his pop and tell a sob story about being robbed at gunpoint. He'll convince his old man that Morello can't protect the merchandise. They'll need to find a new buyer out here, and he's heard of a stand-up guy named Salieri.
This plan is some bullshit, Tom. Polly told it to me yesterday, and somehow it's gotten worse.
Hey, when you get a lead for the boss, and you don't just drive him places, then you get to pick holes. Till then, shut your damn mouth.
Whatever helps you sleep. When Morello tracks you down, don't come crying to me.
You serious? You actually serious?
Fellas, knock it off. Christ.
Careful!
That was close. Yeah, it looks a little fucked up.
I do a lot of deals here. Parking attendant don't ask for much dough. Always closes up shop till I'm done.
Okay, we're good. Gates is waiting up on the top floor.
Come on, let's go!
The max limit.
Place seems clear so far.
Only people with cars are people with jobs. 9 to 5, place is deserted.
Well, we got jobs and we're here.
That kind of a job, sure.
Anything else we need to know about Gates, Polly?
Only that he's got a bust-up nose and crates full of the good stuff.
Our kind of guy.
Our kind of guy. Park up over there.
Polly! Good to see you, pal.
Yeah, you too, Gates.
Well, I hope you all have good taste in whiskey.
I ain't really the expert here. Tommy.
Oh, yeah. It's fine. Your first payment. If the Don's impressed, he'll finance more runs.
And each one's gonna be bigger than the last. We're all gonna be rich, boys.
Well, we are always happy to do business with good folks like Don Salieri. Please, give him my regards.
Sure thing. Now we just gotta conclude this transaction.
Damn it, Polly!
No! It's okay.
Oh. What? I told you, we gotta make it look like a proper robbery.
Damn, things gonna be crooked by the time I'm done with this city.
Ah, don't worry, pal. With all the dough you're raking in, you're gonna be able to pay for a new one.
Watch out!
Oh, shit! God damn it! Battle it together, Polly!
God damn it!
Damn it.
My guys will come for me.
Now go! So long as you guys clear them out up ahead, I'll be safe here with the little guy.
Carlo, in the cab with me. You know you're dead. Tommy, check for more of them. This thing ain't over.
Come on, I'll back you up.
Escort the truck. Oh, shit. This isn't gonna be fun. Wait on me, fam. Painful. Ooh, grenades.
Keep the boots safe. I'm gonna turn over. You see more, you shoot them.
gotcha.
All right, first floor.
Grab a set of wheels and watch my back.
Sure, Sam.
Deal.
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the bulls back to the warehouse and try not to die.
I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay, let's slow them down some.
Hit them where it hurts!
Damn, it's gonna be close.
Sam's going through the Hooverville.
So I guess we are too.
There actually is a Hooverville. Come on, please be close. Oh boy.
I think we lost them all.
Thank Christ for that. Let's head home, see what we got.
We got the booze. I mean, I know it didn't go to plan, but we got the booze.
Yeah. Though tonight, me and you are gonna drink a bunch of it.
I guess we earned that much.
Looks like a 38. Morello's boys caught up with you?
Yeah, boss. We took care of it.
What about the kid from Kentucky?
Well, he took a slug to the shoulder. But, he's a tough blocker. He and his crew dusted out as soon as we bumped off Morello's hatchet, man.
Getting shot will give Gates and his pop another reason to ice Morello out of the whiskey business.
Well, let's see if this hooch was worth all the trouble. Excellent. I'll work out the details with Papa Gates. But once we're running this Kentucky Brown, we'll be back in brass buttons. Good work, son. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of all of you. Saludo!
Saludo!
Hell yeah. Alright, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like, post a comment, and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.